Next Saturday on 4, the Anglo-Indians, a community dating back to the very beginnings of empire.
We were regarded as the pillars of British imperialism, brought deliberately into existence by the British to serve their imperial interests, which we did.
One of my friends is 82.
After independence, most Anglo-Indians stayed on, some remaining quaintly aloof, others becoming sadly detached from Indian life and the rest of their own community.
Our type of living is very different. We live actually for the day.
Being an Anglo-Indian, you really don't get a job. The moment you tell them your good name, you know, and they get your title there, an Anglo-Indian, they tell you, we'll let you know. That let you know means you'll never see it, that office again, right?
A two-part documentary, The Anglo-Indians, begins next Saturday at 7:30 here on 4.
After the break, we head for Newcastle University, where the most searching questions are not to be found in the exam papers. Questions about cuts, research, and funding. Answers seem to be pretty thin on the ground, except in Edinburgh, where lecturer Dennis McEwan takes his students to meet the Moonies.
Thank you. Thank you.
Now, from Mozart's measured tones to the uneven tempo of life at Newcastle University, where, in the middle of the second term, the cry is still to cut. Redbrick.